Top story this hour, though. Police investigations into the Koregaon Bheem violence incident in India has led to a massive revelation. Police in the state of Maharashtra, after arresting Naxal sympathizers, have found a letter that accuses, or rather discusses, the assassination of the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi along the lines of the former Prime Minister of the country, Rajiv Gandhi. The letter was signed with the initial R and written to a comrade Prakash. The letter says that the mission might be suicidal in nature, but that it is an issue which should be considered by higher-ups in the organization. It further says that Mr. Modi has been unable to establish governments in 15 states and his party is bulldozing its way into the lives of Adivasis or tribals. Now, the letter also states that Modi's continuation in public life could mean great trouble for the underground Maoist organizations. It's a matter of great concern that Maoist organizations are planning to assassinate the Prime Minister. Remember, the former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated by LTTE terrorists. WION's political editor Kartikeya Sharma joining me live on the broadcast for more on the story. Disturbing news, definitely, Kartikeya. Bring us up to speed with the contours of the developments, so to speak.
It's a pretty shocking development. To put in perspective for our viewers, you know, the violence which took place in Koregaon Bheem, people thought that, you know, this was primarily a result of the fact that there were a lot of atrocities taking place against the Dalit community. So, you know, it expressed itself in form of some, you know, violent events. But the historical context of that was that Marathas under Peshwais were against Dalits, and Dalits fought with the Britishers against the Peshwais. So, you know, what we consider from the narrative of political struggle, but from the Dalit perspective, it used to be persecution by the Peshwas. But setting that aside, now in the modern context, it's more on the line of Ambedkarite politics, more on the line of Dalit politics. And when the investigation took place, the first part was that somehow Naxals or the people in profession in urban centers instigated the people who had come there, which is an annual ritual, to indulge in violence. Subsequently, again, the investigation took place because they were arrested. Then, the phones, the laptops, the papers, all of them were confiscated by the police. And then this letter was discovered that there was a proposal, and there is a proposal to assassinate Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the lines of Rajiv Gandhi. To take a recall back, Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated at a time when he did not have an SPG cover. He was assassinated by LTTE terrorists.
Right.
But in this case, you know, the Prime Minister does have a SPG cover, but to imagine or to plan, and even when he goes out for his rallies, is something, you know, will put intelligence agencies on alert, Aisha, because you would remember in Banaras, when he went out for the rally, during state assembly elections, he started to walk and a lot of objections were made by SPG. So there are a number of times Prime Minister have done that during electoral process.
Right.
So
and
I think
course
it's a matter
SPG,
of great concern.
Absolutely. And the SPG obviously has its concerns and protocol has to be maintained, even though the Prime Minister does enjoy interacting with people one-on-one. Kartikeya, also, before we move on, I wanted to ask you, you know, just in context of the BJP government's, let's say, attitude towards Maoists and these organizations, it's been rather no-nonsense so far. But do you think this is also an approach that has antagonized, let's say, Naxalite organizations in the country to the extent that they're actually considering something as grave as this?
I think, you know, this is also because of the fact, Aisha, of the experience of the previous government. I still remember I was in the press conference. Shivraj Patil was the Home Minister. There was a moratorium with the Naxalites. Congress gave 2 years to Naxalites so that, you know, there can be talks. But what happened was that the Maoists actually backstabbed the Congress. They, instead of coming on table to talk, they reorganized themselves, and then, you know, there was mayhem in Dantewada. That is why when Chidambaram went on to become the chief, the Home Minister, he organized a campaign called Operation Green Hunt. So I think there is a political consensus that what Naxalites have done is to destabilize number of internal areas, and they are the biggest internal enemies, because the problem of poor Adivasi as opposed to the, you know, the industrialist and capitalist is now being exploited by the Maoists, and it's no more about Adivasis getting their rights over the minerals or the suffering, the curse of the resources, but it has become an organized, I would say, militancy, and that no state can tolerate.
Absolutely. Kartikeya, thank you for joining us this afternoon and bringing us up to speed.